Hello and welcome back to a brand new video. It's been a long old while since my last video, so I do apologise for that. Yeah, before we get into it, if you are new, make sure you like, subscribe as always. It's going to be a lot more consistent on this channel and my second channel as well, which is down below. Also, before we get into talking about Chiquinho and what he's about and my opinion on him, make sure you go and check out Talking Wolves video on him, because it's a lot more in depth. They go into a lot more detail about the player himself, how he'll fit into our system, his background in football. There's a lot more detail, and here I'm just going to give my opinion. So yeah, there's a link in the description to the Talking Wolves video. Highly recommend you go check that out. But yeah, let's get into my opinion on Chiquinho. Brand new signing for Wolves, and it is the signing of Portuguese winger Chiquinho. I think it's Chiquinho, Chiquinha. I'm not too sure on the pronunciation. But yeah, Wolves are about to sign the Wolves winger from Estoril in Portugal. When I saw this being linked and when it was in advanced talks, I did go and have a look to see where Estoril were in the Portuguese top flight, because I'll be honest, didn't really know too much about Estoril as a club, really. But yeah, they're actually having a really good season. They're kind of in sixth place, I believe, now with a game in hand, which could take them to fifth, which they'll pretty much be the best of the rest. You know, the main top three, and then Braga's right under that. Then, you know, it's pretty much everyone else for themselves. And you'd say they're pretty much the best of the rest at the moment. And I think Chiquinho has been a big part of that as well. Still a very young winger, 21 years of age. Like everyone else, when their club's about to sign pretty much unknown player, you always go on YouTube, put the name in, watch their skill compilations, and that's exactly what I did. And, you know, he's a very, very tricky winger, very quick. I think the best way I could describe him as a player is very similar to Wilfried Zaha in his build and the way he plays, his playing style. Very similar to Wilfried Zaha, Rory, or some Maximin maybe. Gets targeted a lot. You can see where we see it a lot with Adama as well, where, you know, always try and put two men on him or try and just hack him down so he doesn't get away. Very similar styles, to be fair. And yeah, we're signing him from Estoril for, I think it's around 3.5 million euros with 1.5 million in add-ons or something like that. So pretty much risk-free, really. I'm pretty sure over time we can make that money back quite easily. So yeah, it's probably not what every Wolves fan would have wanted. A lot of people would have prioritised, including myself, would have prioritised a defender or a midfielder as well, just to bulk out the team, really, with Sace away on international duty or at the AFCON. And just a lot of injuries as well. We kind of needed another midfielder, defence-minded player. But yeah, again, like I said, pretty much risk-free. Not going to take up a whole lot of wages either. And like I said before, the type of winger he is kind of the ones we've had over the years. Very tricky, very skillful. It seems his end product's actually quite good. He's got a very nice cross on him. Can play on either side, left or right wing. And something that is, I think, a very good strong point in Chiquinho is that his defensive work as well. From playing for a team like Estoril as well, you know, you're always going to do that bit more defending and that bit more tracking back to help your fullback, whether you're at, you know, you could be at Sporting or Benfica, then, you know, you've got a lot more possession. You don't have to track back as much. But I think playing at a club like Estoril, you know, mid-table Portuguese side, you're going to have to do a lot of tracking back when you're playing the bigger teams. So I think that's a big advantage as well for Wolves as well, because, you know, I think that's something we've always wanted, just for you to work hard, help your fullbacks out. And I think it'll be perfect for Bruno Lage as well. And we know how good he is with the young players, and see what he's like. And yeah, I think it's going to be interesting to see what we do with him, because it's still unsure whether we're going to keep him or whether we're going to send him out on loan. It's still unsure about that. For me, I wouldn't really be too bothered either way. I could see it going. I wouldn't really mind seeing him keep with the squad until the summer, maybe see what his progression's like. And even, you know, training with the first team, and every now and then get a few minutes for the under-23s. Just, you know, keep him fit, keep him sharp. And, you know, I think I definitely will keep him, because we're still, like I said, we're still thin on the ground with players at the moment. You know, Neto's probably not back for he probably wouldn't be back playing a game for maybe another month or so. He'll probably be back in training in the next week or so, in the next few weeks. So yeah, I'd still keep him around the squad for now, up until the summer, and see what his development's like. Learning under Bruno Lage. Then if he needs to go on loan maybe to a Portuguese side or somewhere else in Europe, then we'll see about that. But yeah, I think overall, I said risk-free. I think it's a good move for everyone. I think for the player itself, I think, you know, getting a move to a big league in the Premier League, getting to learn under, you know, I think it's renowned for how good he was with young players and nurturing young players. Bruno Lage was at Benfica, so I think it's great for him. It's great for Estoril as well, because, you know, they're probably going to get around €5 million for him, which I think for a club like Estoril, you know, who don't get a lot of money, all the money goes to the big 3-4 in Portugal. I think that's going to be some great money for them as well. And for Wolves, you know, it's relatively cheap. You know, we're not really going to risk too much with him. So I think overall, it's a good deal for everyone. But yeah, as always, let me know your thoughts on the whole deal in the comments down below, as always. And yeah, hopefully you guys did enjoy this video. Like I said, a lot more videos coming up. Hopefully a few more signing videos as well before the end of the transfer window. But we'll see about that. But yeah, hopefully you guys did enjoy. Make sure you like, subscribe as always. Twitter, Instagram, second channel down below. Make sure you go follow them. And yeah, hopefully you all stay well, stay safe, and I will see you in the next one. She calls me day and night. I'm sorry, girl, you just don't make me feel right.